trying out the opponent is very important. It's very important to try out your opponent if you know nothing about your opponent. You have to try to find out what kind of fighter he is. Point is, you want to find out what his strong points are. This can be found out by faking a lot and irritate him, so he wants to attack, but be aware for every counter if you irritate him. Again, keep an eye contact with your opponent and try to move out the corner. We're exercising this not on full power, but on speed and fluidness. I irritate him with easy things like jabs and inside leg kicks. trying out the opponent is very important. It's very important to try out your opponent if you know nothing about your opponent. You have to try to find out what kind of fighter he is. Point is that you want to find out what his strong points are. This can be found out by faking a lot and irritate him, so he wants to attack, but be aware for every counter if you irritate him. Again, keep an eye contact with your opponent and try to move out the corner. We're exercising this not on full power, but on speed and fluidness. I irritate him with easy things like jabs and inside leg kicks. Don't make too difficult combinations. That's only a big risk. Stick with one or two punches or a kick. Also, we fake once in a while to see his reaction. Remember, don't make the combinations too difficult. Just make one punch or one kick. It's just why you want him to show something. Let's see how this applies in a fight. Here you can see I'm testing out my opponent. Watch how I'm testing my opponent. I'm moving and faking a lot to irritate him. Stay alert at all times when irritating in the beginning of a fight your opponent. How to deal with an attacking fighter. Here I show how to deal with an attacking fighter. You look first and I will explain later. I try to keep my opponent on distance with short combinations and follow up with leg kicks. I turn away and don't let him put me in the ropes. While turning away, I kick his legs. He has to recover and get in the right position again. You can see how I turn away of the corner and place him in the ropes and have a possibility to counter. By giving short combinations and following up with the leg kick, we control the distance. You can see I'm moving to the ring. I'm moving sidewards to the left and to the right. But I'll keep my opponent busy. Another possibility is while giving him the feeling he can come in and keep him away with a push kick and a front knee and hard body kicks. Turn away and counter.
Il va se précipiter sur Kaman pour essayer de conclure.
Here I show how to deal with an attacking fighter. Try to move backwards and sidewards and try to counter.
Il va se précipiter sur Kaman pour essayer de conclure. Il replace encore une droite.
You can see I turn away while he wants to put me in the ropes.
Le paquet, comme on dit. Et il a raison.
Watch how my left jab is stopping him off.
Le paquet, comme on dit. Et il a raison. Avec les pieds, tellement les deux boxeurs veulent faire la décision quasiment sur un coup.
By moving backwards and keeping my balance in the center, I give a good counterpunch with my right hand. He's not only a boxing type of fighter, he can take a punch too.
Toute la chance de Kaman maintenant réside dans son travail de jambes avec une garde bien fermée, hermétique.
Again, the left jab. Beware of the counter, as you can see. And a push kick when he's moving forward to keep the right distance. Watch how my first punch take away his sides and I'm following up with the right uppercut. Dealing with a boxing type of fighter. When I deal with a boxing type of fighter, I try to do like I show here with my partner. In this slow motion, we'll try to show you how to handle a boxing type of fighter. A puncher needs to come close and needs a good balance, so I keep him busy with flurry punches, and when he comes in my reach, I grab him, turn him in the ropes and counter on his legs. Again, you grab in and you counter and end up with a leg kick. punches I make are not so hard, but he has to block them. And when he wants to punch, he's in my reach. You can see, I grabbed him, turned him on the ropes and counter on his legs. When he's in my range, I grab him good and turn him right away in the ropes. Don't wait too long, he's able to punch, and I'll follow up with punches and a leg kick.
Bonne droite du Polonais. Et changement de tactique chez le Hollandais qui se sert maintenant de sa...
I'm showing you how to deal with a boxing fighter. But in real, it's not as easy as within training. You get hit for real. But still, you have to move and turn away and counter. That's what I try here to do. You can see, by stepping backwards and reviewing the situation, I can counterpunch and I stay in eye contact with my opponent.
Well, bonne droite du Polonais. Et changement de tactique chez le Hollandais qui se sert maintenant de sa jambe arrière gauche.
By way of pushing your opponent and stepping back in the basic position, you can review the situation. This is important with the boxing type of fighter. Dealing with a static fighter. If your opponent is a static fighter, so he moves so much, you have to move around him and irritate him as much as possible. By irritating him, he will take action. So I move around him and irritate him a lot with quick punches and kicks, inside leg kicks and jabs to the face, so he gets a little bit angry. While irritating him and making a lot of points, he has to do something back. So be aware when he does. Especially when your opponent gets angry, he starts making mistakes. He don't think so good and makes mistakes. But be always aware for attacks. And if he attacks, you have to be sure your counters are hard and effective. While irritating my opponent, I'm making a lot of points. Of course, in a real fight, this will give me a good advantage in one round on points. So maybe in the later rounds, he has to force the fight because he's behind on points. When your opponent has to force the fight, make sure your counters are hard and effective. Here you can see how I deal with a static TIE fighter. I irritate him and wait for his attack. You can see I start to irritate my opponent while giving a left inside low kick. I move around and I make him nervous. And I'm faking. Watch now, I block his kick and counter with a right low kick. If you are a tall fighter, it's no use to be attacking all the time. You have to use your reach and fight on a distance. I keep my opponent on a distance with front kicks, jabs, leg kicks and front knees and move sidewards. When he comes in my reach, I grab him and don't let him go anymore. This part I cannot show anymore because there was a little accident. A left high kick to the head hits my partner. But to keep your opponent on distance, it's important that he's gonna take more risk to get in on you. And from these mistakes, you have to take advantage. The part, what I can't show you anymore, is that when my partner is in my reach, I grab him and hit him with knee and don't let him go. We saw this little accident happen. Of course the producer immediately told Rob's partner that he should drop his defense again and repeat his action. Unfortunately, he wouldn't listen. Here, I try to imitate a short fighter. A short fighter always have to move in and have to take risks. A short fighter has to move a lot and be a busy fighter. He has to make a lot of combinations with his hands and follow with leg kicks and body kicks. You see that the short fighter has to move in and has to take risks. The short fighter has to move in and out and fake a lot to find and create openings in the defense. Also, backing up your opponent and put him in the ropes is important. Try to force him to fight in your rhythm, and don't let him come in his own rhythm. Sparring with boxing is to get rhythm and timing and distance. It's good for your balance and develop your combination ability, if you do it right. Sparring is not standing toe to toe, and try to hit each other as hard as you can. If that's what you thought, you have the wrong idea of sparring. It's giving each other the possibility to try something new, a combination of footwork. So we're trying out evasion, combination, footwork, slips, but we do it relaxed. Later, if everything goes well, you can put more pressure and power, but it's still sparring and not a real fight. So the main reason we spar is to get rhythm, timing and distance. It's good to develop your combination ability if you do it right. Watch how I keep eye contact with my opponent. It'll help me and keep me in advantage by counterpunching. Watch again how I keep my balance in the center and I move around my opponent by taking little steps to the side. You can hear that the punches are relaxed, it's not a big bang. We just relax by sparring and we don't hit each other to hurt each other. Try out everything, not only come forward and throw in your punches, but evade and fake as well. The clinching I train always on the end of the training. I start with grabbing each other around the neck and try to get your arms to the inside and pull your opponent off balance with short pulls on his neck and step sideways. So you try to pull your opponent off balance. By giving short jerks, you will be off balance. I try always to stand up, straight up. Don't let your opponent pull you down. Don't use too much power during clinching. It's a lot of techniques. It's not only power. Use the power of your opponent at that point. Just take a look at our clinching. total sparring is like boxing sparring, for timing, distance and combination of footwork, and not to hurt each other. Move forwards and backwards and try to do everything what's possible. You can do it. The more you try, the more you will do in the ring. Try out every combination, clinch and footwork, the more experience you get. You'll start to recognize also more things from your opponent. The way how he fights, moves and attacks. A good fighter can adapt to every fighting style, so try to fight like all fighters, long, tall, static and boxing type. This kind of sparring is not to hurt each other. Again, it's for timing, distance, combination and footwork. It's nice to try out your footwork, clinching and combinations to get more experience in fighting. Notice that it's only possible when you are relaxed and your partner as well. Again, notice that a good fighter can adapt to every fighting style, so try to fight like all fighters, long, tall, static or a boxing type. A good fighter is an all-round fighter. Everything we learned, we can put in the sparring, the redirect, fake, takeovers, clinching, whatever we would like. Remember, a good fighter is an all-round fighter. In this tape, I show you which training methods you can use to prepare you for a fight. Try to pick out the things which you feel will work for you and your fighting career. Good luck and have fun!